Hi, Dr. Bob Flower, and this is your Friday the 13th, love it, Master Pattern Report. Okay, so let's see how we did last week. On the silver, we were going for a move on the 6th, the 4th and the 6th, and we did get a move on the 9th, which is one calendar day. Remember, our program is within a day of our call, and it dropped by 5%. Oil did make its gradual move up and will continue into the summer, and the Nasdaq, the QQQ, also made a nice move and bottomed on the 6th, and it's been bouncing back and forth here. So what we're looking at coming up is we see another move on silver next week on the 16th, and the Nasdaq on the 19th. Now, we are still maintaining a short position for the market through May. We still think that there's going to be some major turn here, events. It may only be temporary, but we definitely feel we're going to see them. We are again bullish on the metals, silver. Gold is making a nice move. Silver is not necessarily following, but it is, as you'll notice, you look at the charts over the past 3 weeks or so, it is making a nice move up, and we are long silver, we are long oil, and we are short the Nasdaq, the QQQ, and we intend on staying in that position at least until the end of May. Okay, so what do we think these events may be contributed to, supported by? Well, right now, if I had to guess, it looks like South America is where we're going to see some major problems here, where we're going to see some major breakdowns. You have several countries there that are in big trouble. Brazil, don't be surprised if this Olympics ends up to be a huge disaster, huge bust. Of course, Venezuela and Argentina does not look good either. This may very well be precipitated by some disasters there. You're going to see Greece once again raise its ugly head, and this time I don't know if they're going to be able to resolve this. Depending on its resolution, you may see England dropping out of the EU. So, and if that happens, it's all over, folks. I mean, then we really know that we're in serious trouble. We are in serious trouble, and the shorts are way up. The big guys are bailing out on a number of their favorite stocks. Company execs are bailing out. So, I mean, these are all pretty strong indicators as to what's going on. And by the way, a lot of real estate markets are not happening. They're just falling flat. So, which is what we expected, and as we stated, we think that next year will be a not very good year for real estate. I don't see it tanking as bad as it has in the past, but keep that in mind if you're going to be investing. Make sure you've got a real strong out, whatever real estate investment you make, and you're not leveraged to the hilt. We are revamping our website. We're making it more business and professional development oriented. I think you're really going to like it. It's going to be based on our Laws of Potential, and our new motto for the Laws of Potential is no more excuses for mediocrity. Okay, with the laws of potential, everybody can make money. Everybody can do well, right? And you'll see that exposed on the on our new website, which we hope to have completed by the end of the month, first week or so in June. Okay, so we're holding our course here, sort of doubling down, if you will. So one other thing I want to mention to you. Last year I mentioned that what will really precipitate a downfall would be a weak dollar, the metals will start to make a move, and including oil and your fuels, and that is what is happening. More and more countries are going to the acquisition of gold, and in some cases silver and platinum and palladium and whatnot. So, I mean, these are all indicators that behind the scenes that there's patterns that are going on that are not positive. So let's try and follow the quote leaders, and let's stay ahead of the curve. Okay. Have a good Friday the 13th. I know I don't sound like I'm having a good one, but it's better than the alternative. Have a good one.